Anyway, so I'd like to welcome you guys to this impromptu like talk show thingy.
Meeting.
Considering ano kasi, I mean, we all know affected tayong lahat yung events natin because of COVID and yun. So me, I do the whole War Machine thing. You guys do the whole Age of Sigmar side rin naman. So I guess it'll be good for like the players to get to hear from their EOs. So before that, siguro introduce lang natin siguro sarili natin. It's just too bad Carlo
is
unable.
Yeah, hopefully you'll be able to join us soon enough.
Tubo diretso lang. We'll just
here.
So me and MK, I've been EO for, well, before War Machine, I've been EOing Warhammer Fantasy. Lapang Age of Sigmar nung time na yun, and 40K. Helping with 40K. But now, well, pre-COVID, it was just a lot of War Machine. And how about you, Liam?
So, my name's Liam, and I've been doing EO for... Actually, it's not that long. If I had to count, it was like, because I only managed to do an actual event once, and that was during the time when Age of Sigmar was still somewhat new. The new General's Handbook, the first General's Handbook came out, and then we started to go with the idea that we invite new players that just entered into the community and held a tournament for the newcomers, which was called Munchkin at the time. So after that, I went on a year of hiatus from doing an EO. Pero pag merong mga ibang tao kasi that tried to do a tournament and needed like help in terms of organizing or trying to answer players' inquiries, I tend to be there naman to help whenever I can.
Awesome.
So
yun, goes without saying, we're all hit pretty bad by COVID. I was hoping to attend one of your events for Age of Sigmar. I was getting some demons prepared pa nga eh. So hopefully join you guys. I think you guys have a grand tournament planned also for this year.
Supposed to be supposed to be, it was gonna be held at March 21, pero due to the COVID-19 outbreak, we decided to cancel it. It was actually we didn't want to make the final say like kami-kami lang with Neutral Grounds and myself na sabihin namin we'll just cancel it. So I did a parang unanimous vote for every single one of the ones who are participating in the tournament. It was interesting kasi it was like a half, almost half vote na gustong matend pa rin. And then, and the rest was like,
we'll with Papa Nurgle.
We're gonna play. Pero at the end of the day, parang it was kind of hard as well kasi we realized it was impossible to make it in such a way na we didn't want the store to be held accountable if something were to happen. That's one of the biggest fears that I had. Because since this was a official NG sponsored sort of event, adamay din sila if ever na something were to happen in one of the participants. So we
Actually, naalala ko pa yung time na yun nung I think it was you guys, yata. You had like a gig at War Room. It was a Saturday, and I was supposed to be on my way, but there was like news the previous day about COVID happening nangyari sa Green Hills area. But like I was, oh no, I'm not
gonna, yeah.
I'm not gonna go.
Not gonna go.
Cause I'm like fat man. I'm
yeah.
I have hypertension. Yeah. I'm gonna get that. So yun palang tigil kagad ako nung time na yun. Pero I mean like yeah, I mean after all that, yeah, all our events was like put to a standstill. Even I think I have like a Three Kings thing going on for War Machine.
Hindi rin yun nga, it was like what, it was kind of ironic because it's been like for me and Zach, we tried to schedule for a game, and then when we did get a schedule, COVID came in and we were like, oh no, like I planned everything, nagrush pa naman ako for all my models to get finished up para at least when we take the pictures, okay sana.
But it's like, stupid anon. I was hoping by the end of March it'd be done.
Yeah, at least
over with.
Yeah.
Bigla na lang, tuloy-tuloy siya.
Yeah,
it was crazy.
It was so dumb.
So like like we all know ngayon,
Mahidra, Carlo?
Yes.
Yon.
Oh,
Carlos with us.
I'm okay, na. Yes. I'm okay.
Voice I am my voice, pero no, it's okay. Walang no screen. Video. Yeah, no video.
Let me try with video.
There you go. We see you.
Hello.
Hello everyone. Sir. It's Carlo.
How are you guys doing?
Ayun.
I got
so Carlo, one of our I think all of us.
All of us are long.
Too long.
Yep, and all of us have long hair. I mean, and you have a very long beard, Liam. My God.
Uy, hindi ah, mas mahaba pa yun dati. I just recently got a shave, so.
A shave.
Si Carlo naabutan ko pa siya nag. Nagwa-warcry dun sa CNC. Di ba? That was yung last time nakita ko si Carlo pa. Si Liam sa War Room.
That was the tournament. Yeah, tournament ng Warcry. The first ever tournament of Warcry. Yeah,
it
was the last time we saw each other.
Mark.
Oh, nga eh.
So, judge ka. Oh, awesome. Anyway, we were talking about yun nga, yung how stupid COVID affected all our events.
Yes, definitely.
Is there anything new with the Age of Sigmar side this year? Like, I'm pretty sure you guys have been keeping up to date. Alam ko merong 9th edition for 40k.
Well, for one thing though, based on some of the rumor engines I've been reading, there's an upcoming General's Handbook 2020. So I don't know if it's going to be before 9th edition of 40k or after, but it did say that around this month, June, from the shipping manifest. So expect that there's going to be. I really don't know what's there to be changed in General's Handbook because
the new.
I mean, the past armies from version 1, AOS version 1, and from Warhammer Fantasy Battle, they've already been incorporated. So what GW is doing now is they're just adding new factions. Vampire Owls.
I think the smart move for any gaming company now is to facilitate probably online games, tabletop simulator, Vassal, War Machine side. Some guys made their own custom war table.
Yes, I saw that on the page.
Interestingly enough, if I remember correctly, GW currently has been pushing for a lot of like the digital games. The best example I can think of is yung Warhammer Underworlds. It was interesting because I was quite surprised by that.
Sorry to interrupt. There's a sale on Steam.
Yeah, there
Blood for the Blood.
Sayang.
Freaking 75% off, man. Sakit sa buhay.
Yeah.
Oh no. I went for the Inquisitor. Like,
oh, we're still in quarantine.
I went for Inquisitor.
Ah, yeah. Good game.
Yeah.
And Dawn of
War. I also bought the Dawn of War 1 series. Me and my brother are currently playing it, and he's still very much
getting beaten by me. In that different chat, kung ano yung reactions niyo, sabi niyo, get Dawn of War 2. So I got that one, not 3.
Don't get Dawn of War 3.
Don't get 3. I kind of legally downloaded Dawn of War 3 to try before I buy. And yes, definitely, sir. The graphics are good. The graphics are good, but gameplay-wise,
It's like you're playing Dota, but you're controlling massive armies instead of like one hero. So,
hey, Total War is on sale for that, man. Parang Total War.
I managed to get most of the DLCs because of said sale, so medyo worth the.
Have you guys tried playing yung mga Vassal stuff or Tabletop
Simulator? Actually, me and Carlo have I think 2 games. We played 2 games using Tabletop Simulator.
I'm supposed to be the server.
Is it heavy? Is it what's the experience?
You explain, Liam.
Graphically wise, I don't think it's that heavy. Ang pinaka, like the major thing that's like really required for the thing to run smoothly on both ends is for the host to have a really good internet connection. Because it's like the server is reliant on your internet, the one who's hosting. Yes. So ako yung nag-host on our P2P connection. So and gameplay wise it was pretty fun, pero of course it's not gonna be able to beat the actual dice rolling.
Yeah, that's true.
Tapos on a 1,000 point game, usually you would expect like half an hour and a half na matatapos ko na sa game play.
And
but
of course,
we ended up being like 2.5 hours or 3 hours. Tapos sa kami sa 1K game,
that was
we
your
like,
first.
Oh,
that was your first game. So
yeah, that's true.
We were still trying.
Kasi ang biggest problem kasi namin was the fact that if we're playing a horde army and we want to move the pieces individually in a specific move, but it was like, oh man, click, drop, click, drop, per piece.
You can actually select it all, pero you know, for the sake of strategy.
Meron mga moments kasi na parang you have to literally do a specific parang
and also the physics. Because there's some bugs on it, so like the physics, like in one time, Liam just dropped his one model, then suddenly all the models around sa na-drop niya nag
nagkalat or tumama or something.
Yun actually yung one of the reasons na like I like brought this up, kasi some guys like are planning to probably scratch their itch and do their tournaments using virtual tabletop stuff. Pero yun nga, what if like yun connection issues or
that's mishap happened. And also everyone will have a good connection, not everyone will have everyone's willing to buy
also say for example you have 6 players in total, right? So you're doing a 2 versus 2 versus 2. Ang problem kasi nun is currently in tabletop sim, you can only have essentially 2 players fighting each other on one room
board.
So you have you have to create 3 rooms. But the problem is, how is the EO going to be able to view all of those? So what ends up happening is, isa-isa muna ang gagawin natin before we move on to the next, which takes forever then.
Tapos ladder match, elimination.
It's elimination. And biggest issue nga talaga doon is connection. I mean, if we wanna play talaga TTS, be the server.
although I've tried also Vasal. Vasal is it's essentially tabletop sim, but this one is more accurate kasi you get to view the models on a top-down perspective. So
I think
yung talaga ng mga base.
I think it's pronounced Vasal.
Yeah,
ang problem ni Vassal is it's okay siya if you're playing Guild Ball or War Machine with flat terrain. But because it's knowing like 40k accurate. Or Age of Sigmar, where like elevation is part of the actual game experience, medyo dun lacking si Vassal. So yun yung problem sa kanya. Unless ayos lang na flat and stuff, and then you just say these are obstructions and or whatever. Because of course, I mean, mahirap maging picky during this time.
Interestingly enough, kasi it was one of those things wherein me and Carlo didn't really care about like talagang magdidikit ba yan, whatever. Sige, sabihin
is
na natin.
Is it 2 inches? What's good about the Tabletop Simulator is...
we didn't record, but I did took a picture of some like the gameplay. Yeah. So,
what's good about it though is it has a very good measurement system, so you can always check measurement very precise. From 0.12 to 11, ganon. So
the guys who did War Table and the Guild Ball module for Vassal. Napaka pag pick up mo sa kanya, pag land mo sa 6 inches. Uy, basang-basa. Wala kang kawala, bro. Yun talaga yun.
As a Vassal nga, is basically parang planning mode nga talaga. Mm-hmm. I mean, top-down planning mode. If it's from Total War, yun yung parang ano, overview mode.
What do you guys think GW is doing with regards to his Age of Sigmar, considering itong global situation
now. Well, apart from the delays from the releases, which everyone's already looking forward to, the Lumineth Realm Lords, the high elves,
the light elves,
we call them the cow elves, na lang.
Cow elves.
Yes, because that's their theme. I don't know. For you, sir, what's your opinion on the aesthetic, Sir Kim?
I'm sorry, I like those pointy high elves. Pero astig yung bagong tech list, but beyond that, no.
I actually had an argument.
Imric on Dragon, that this new cow thing, I don't know what they were thinking about that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, they
actually had an argument about it because like Chaos Dwarves have this motif and aesthetics of like bulls as well, and I was but they're still being usable in Age of Sigmar. So how is
Chaos
GW
Dwarves confirm?
What they're
I don't know
about their Forge World.
Yeah, they're Forge World. That's true.
Yeah, they're Forge World.
We've seen a couple of moves from GW because we're in. They're like, we'll make some of the models from GW, but the big badass ones and the more important ones are gonna be made by Forge World. Kind of like what they did with the Horus Heresy, wherein the Mark III Power Armor.
The Primarch.
Yeah. Ano sa Cow Elves yung Forge World? Wala, di ba? That's all.
There is the Chaos Dwarves. Some of their one of their named characters. I keep forgetting his name, but he was the one riding a bull or a Taurus on a mounted. With wings or something like that, because they have in the lore they have this they worship this god called Hashut, who is essentially like a fire demon of some sort that sometimes they would represent to him as like a bull. That's why they have like dwarves that are half bullish features. They even have the centaurs and stuff like that. And I'm just like, well, the light elves also are worshiping like cows or bulls because they have horns and such. But it's like,
that's all new to me, man. I mean, different.
But yeah, I'm more excited about the new giants, though. That's the only thing I'm
eyeing for. The Sons of Ben. I'm very curious because of how they will affect the gameplay, because I'm really suspecting it to be like
super low ass
highlight by anyone.
In 40k, it's going to be like, I don't know, an Imperial Knight meta. Because
as for
GW,
Night Titans,
it's gonna be they can be allied to anyone, which is kind of weird.
Yeah, it's weird because it's like, how the hell am I gonna ally Storm? Well, no, sorry. Then again, though, there was a fluff before that I read where in the Stormcast were like, hey, big ogres, why don't you, instead of eating us, because we're just made out of metal and purely metal and soulless souls.
We'll get
why don't you just
meat.
Yeah, no, yeah, like, well, there is an incoming
orc army. Iron Dust Park. Yeah, that was Gordon.
Yeah, they're more delicious than us. Ally with us.
And yeah, the ogres just agreed.
The big difference with 40k, because the 40k Night Titans, they got guns. These giants,
they got guns.
They don't.
These giants, it's going to affect so much of. Yeah, it's gonna affect so much the gameplay kasi di ko alam pa ano eh, because it's a very much low model count
army. It's a very low model count army.
Kasi if those new giants will be the generals or the heroes, then the smaller giants are around 1. Around
bigger.
200 points? No, the smaller giants. Around 200 points.
Yeah, they're essentially the type of army that you probably couldn't be able to field on a 1,000 point game.
only field two models. Yes. It's just a bit of theory crafting or predictions on my part. I think they're going to have a change on the monsters because currently the monsters of Age of Sigmar are kind of underwhelming. Most of them are underwhelming.
Most of them.
Hey man, di ba yung naglalaro nga kayo sa CNC ng Warcry? They were bringing in the monsters in the game.
That was part of Warcry's quest system where you get to hunt monsters para magkaroon ng prestige. It was pretty cool because you can also in a campaign, you can also do that quest. If you win, you have a chance to tame that and be part of your warband.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's really good.
At the very least, in Warcry terms, the monsters have a very unique mechanic system. Yeah. In the overall AOS game, it's like monsters in general are like just big hulking waste of points sometimes. Especially pagka like, oh, I fielded this amazing huge guy, and then on turn one, your opponent decides to be like, nope, it's dead.
Exactly. Like something. If you have demons, you bring out the big ones. Oh, point sink. Kill it.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Kill that.
You know, the new giants, how would they compare to like yung beast claw ng ogres? Beast claw ng ogres?
That's something that beast claw kasi in game terms, their models, let's say the regular small ogre, it counts as two models when you're counting for how many objectives. How many models you have in the objectives. So one ogre is two. One giant, those giant elephants, they count as 10. Those giant elephant models.
Yeah.
Yes, they count as 10 models. So you can park it in one objective, that's 10 models in there. And because of their good stats, they're very hard to kill.
Yun yung problem they have degrading like stats.
Actually, that was the one thing that I find to be unique in Age of Sigmar and balancing out actually, because there are also some monsters, particularly like
trolls.
What's that name character for Khorne? The
Bloodthirster.
Arbrand.
Scarbrand. He's one of the only monsters in Age of Sigmar at the moment wherein if he gets lower in terms of his wounds, he gets better in combat. So you actually want him to almost die and leave him with one wound.
Yeah.
Leave him alone.
And what's terrifying, and what it's terrifying about Scarbrand is if he didn't fight previous turn, he gets angrier on the next turn and he gets better at that fight at least.
Might be like that. Like if they get wounded, they get better.
Well, it depends because there are some. If I remember correctly, the Mangler Squigs from the Moon or the Grots
Gloomspike kids,
wherein if they get lower in terms of their health, something happens to them where they get worse at something but better at the other.
Yes.
Something like that. And that's really, really good. And I hope that they, in the new Age of Sigmar book, there's going to be something that they're going to be adding to monsters. Like what Carlo mentioned, it's kind of unfair for like the Beast Claw Raiders for their monsters to have this particular ability wherein they count as 10 models when they secure an objective. And I'm just like, well, my Glotkin should technically count as 10 models in an objective, but like, no,
or
he's
my
not.
Or my Gorgon as well.
Yeah, it's just
kind of predicted that because currently on 40K, they said that they're going to improve vehicles. I haven't played 40K 8th edition, but yeah, I kind of look at their stats, kind of look at the battle reports. Vehicles are very much underwhelming, except flyers though, but of course that's different. But for the land vehicles, going to improve it. So, siguro nga, for Sons of Behemoth, in siguro, it's going to shift. Because, I don't know, I think AOS is going to have another edition shift. Though slightly smaller changes lang siguro.
Yeah, because pero, 19 it, happened. It's not going to be surprising.
Because everything's already set. All the previous armies, Warhammer Fantasy Battles, Empire, Dark Elves, Dwarves, they've already been made into cities. Which is actually a good faction. Hard to get models, but actually a very good faction. So if you have a Warhammer Fantasy army like the Dark Elves, you can do it the Cities of Sigmar. Maintaining within the fluff of their army. So kung Dark Elves, more benefits if it's a pure Dark Elf army. You can do mix though, because it's kind of like the Imperial Guard as well. I mean, Imperium of Man.
I'd like to point out that Cities of Sigmar is like probably the only army that's like considered a soup army.
Definitely. Very, very much soup army, because you can always mix and match. Some have code combinations, some don't. But it's also viable na mono Dark Elves or mono Empire. But like I said, everything's already been set. The last battle tome to be updated was Seraphon. Lizard
Seraphon.
Which is, they're lucky they did not get the nerf bat because of COVID-19.
Not yet.
Insufficient data for them to get nerfed, but yeah.
Halo pa ngayon nga. How was the participant like pre-registration before all the Papa Nurgle went bananas on us? How many did you guys have?
I remember correctly, mine was, or for the grand tournament at the very least, it was
the grand tournament was the last. 22 players.
Yeah,
that's a lot.
It was interesting too, because we were like at the beginning, I was like, you know, I kind of estimate 16 players are gonna join. I think that's
or
enough.
12,
it's gonna fit
actually.
or 12. Yeah, on the neutral ground centers. Yeah, on the venue. And then when it came to the number 20, we were like, okay, is this gonna fit in neutral ground sentence? And then it became 22, and we're like, okay, we have to stop this. Like,
time limit, sir?
Time limit, okay, we have to redo
it. No time limit.
No time
limit, though. Oh, extended. Thanks.
Yay! Awesome, Zoom.
Okay.
First awesome.
Time.
So, thank you,
Zoom. We were panicking, or I was at least panicking at that time, because it was like,
I also scouted the area and 22 players in Old Centris. 22 players in Old Centris. I don't think one could fit
it wasn't
there.
Gonna. Well, it technically it's so compact and tight. But then they assured us that it was gonna fit 22 players, so I just relied essentially on that.
If natuloy yun, Liam, sigurado lahat na tayo may COVID.
Papa Nurgle loves you all.
That wasn't the biggest problem that I had at that time when we counted for it to become 22 players. Nah, finally, the biggest problem that I had for the 22 players was like, how am I gonna be able to provide 11 tables worth of terrain that are at the very least decent enough na it's not gonna be like the typical na yung Magic the Gathering playmat of sorts na black lang siya and then right. You know, so I had to source out from every other people that had terrain. I even encourage players who do have terrain on their personal collection if to donate, you know, to, well, not really donate, but more like, you know, if you sure. want, you can bring your terrain as well contribute. Yeah. I also contacted the War Room as well. Bale, the original plan was I was going to pass by to War Room and collect the terrain that they're willing to contribute for the tournament.
Even the CNC, were, CNC in Alabang. The stuff from Alabang, the mats, the terrain.
Yeah.
Sir Miguel was May going to... Lang
nun, syempre, like,
I was volunteered to...
Coordinating was the hardest part. Tapos, I had to make sure na by the time yung mga terrains na yun nandadun na, I had to make sure na, of course, all of the terrains were accounted for, nothing goes missing. Kasi, especially in a table where there's 22 players, there's bound to be like, mababangga ka or...
You have to check all the tables after every round. Right.
Yeah, that's the hardest part. Kaya nga, we were trying our best. I even prepared the box na kung saan dun ko ilalagay sana label all of the terrains for every person na nag-contribute. But yeah, COVID strike, then somehow it felt like a relief.
It's not a problem pero, anymore.
Huh? It wasn't a problem anymore.
Gonna work on it anymore.
Hey, you know what? I was hoping to in another Zoom sila Mark, the CNC guys. I
saw the Facebook post.
Oh, the first
really
one.
Good.
Yeah. Meron akong na ano with like a glean idea from the new 40K setup because they were the new 40K. What I got from it, they were looking at yun nga starting. Kumbaga, bili ka ng bagong start collecting and then you like make up a story and then done. With all of that, parang nakita ko, I think it's a smart move for GW to standardize their tournaments on 4x4s. What's your take on that? Kasi, I mean, di ba, a lot of the big tables, yun yung isang big logistical problem with like, tournament level 40K or Age of Sigmar, it has to be 6x4. It can't be played on a 4x4.
Interestingly enough, actually, the grand tournament that I was supposed to be TOing for, it was actually one of the first tournaments, I believe. I'm not sure, and everybody can correct me if I'm wrong with this, because I haven't... I've tried doing a couple of research and see if it was the first one. Pero I think this was the first one wherein we tried to encourage players to do a 2,000 point game for Age of Sigmar. Because the general consensus of the community, when we tried to entice them to go for a 2K, it was like, oh, it's too big, points too big. If I'm playing a Horde army, that's like a lot of models. And we're trying to ask
what 1.5
as opposed to no not even 1.5 most of the tournaments that we have held so far for Age of Sigmar 1,000 and the maximum that we had was yung two players versus two players and then tigo 1,000 sila so technically that's 2,000 points but it's kind of like playing essentially 1,000 point game lang din eh kasi you're just controlling an army that's 1,000 points eh. We never had the situation where we're like, okay, players, we're asking you to play 2,000 point game in a 6x4 table. Yeah. So, yeah. But I did ask majority of the players that join in for the tournament and they want to play a 2,000 point game, most of them naman. And we also did, like, I asked Carlo and a couple of people to, like, hey, try out to play 2,000 point game on a 6x4 table and see how long it took for you guys to finish in terms of, you know, doing the objectives and stuff like that. And I was able to compute and we were like, okay, we'll be able to finish the tournament by 7 or 8 p.m. great.
And maybe like 30 minutes for awarding.
9 p.m. 9 a.m.
Yeah, actually, no, that's the other thing that I wanted to encourage a lot of players is because majority of the time, from what I've noticed, the tournament usually starts at 1 or at around 12 o'clock, which is, in my personal opinion, is kind of very late. Even at the 1,000-point game, it's
very late. I mean, the last event we had yun sa war room, that was 1,000 points. Umabot tayo ng around 8 p.m.
8 p.m.?
I was supposed to start from 1, tapos to 8 p.m.
Parang ilang rounds yun?
Yes, 1,000.
It was 3 rounds.
Lang. No breaks.
Then, and nagmamadali
pa kami.
Nagmamadali pa kami because pasan yun ulit, may isa pa sa war room na reserve yun ng 7 p.m. Oh, shit. So, pinadali. Eh, buti na lang, luckily, some players na meron iba, nagparang, hindi for fun na lang, nag-quit na lang for the points na lang kasi walaan sila placing. Because they know,
actually, yun yung una kong parang I told everybody who was participating in the tournament that the tournament was gonna start at 10:30. As in, the moment na nag-hit ng 10:30, if you're late, then I'm so sorry, but it has to be 10:30 because correct. At the end of the day, I wanted all of the players na makauwi kahit papaano ng hindi sobrang late, you know? And the biggest problem was kasi is parang if they're going home at around 10 p.m., I get scared kasi especially some of them who are driving on their way home. Yeah, so, there was one.
Kulay na yun.
There was one I remember who joined in the event sayo Carlo in War Room wherein after work kasi he's working at night and then after
Miguel.
Yeah, si Miguel. Miguel was working at night time and then in the morning he literally went straight for the event and I was like, yo, that's like so it's dedicated. I commend your dedication for the hobby, but at the same time, that's like scary. Kasi who knows? Baka mamaya antukin ka habang nagda-drive.
Oh man,
that's true. Yeah. So
si Miguel yan.
Yeah. Actually, so that's why
the bigger real concern would be. Sige, natapos kayo ng event like 10 or whatever. Pag-uwi mo, galit na si girlfriend, galit na si Macy's, di ka na makakalaro. Di ka na uli makakalaro anytime soon.
Yun nga yung sinasabi ko rin sa mga iba, it's like, this is a one-time thing that happens only once a year. Heck, it might not even happen next year ulit. So, you know, going
to the event
around 10 o'clock in the morning is, you know, parang I don't know if I'm asking too much for the players to wake up early in the morning and prep themselves up to go to the event before 10:30 starts. Pero again, this is only a once in
correct
one big event. Yes. That's it. So
that's true.
I had the same problem with War Machine, and actually it was harder because mas konti. Ang problem kasi with mas konti, there's a sense of entitlement. That comes na hindi magsisimula yung tournament, kulang tao. Yun yung attitude na ayaw akong mangyari. Hindi naman nangyari. But I was yun, fortunate enough na if I say 10 ng umaga, pumupunta sila ng 10 ng umaga. And then they understand, yeah, we need to finish early. Why? Some of them have some of our guys have wives and kids to go home to, man. I mean, okay, right?
Every time that we would go for like or held up a tournament, ang una naming iniisip is, sige, sino sa inyo ang willing mag tawag dito? Mag-replace kung sakaling hindi naman TO, but more like, sino gusto sa inyo ang maging guinea pig?
Bye.
Parang if a player decides to be like na late ako, I cannot attend the event or something like that, and instead of becoming a 22 player naging 21, and I'm like, okay, we got a backup naman kahit papano, so that the one player who doesn't have any opponent whatsoever is not gonna be left out or not gonna be facing anybody on the first round. They're like, no, you're wrong, you're gonna be facing somebody.
That's what I like about yun nga sa group namin, actually for anyone in the community, mostly kasi nga sina Surjas, sina Rap-Rap, they can sometimes make themselves available. Hindi ko nga alam na may dala pala army. Baka nyo na let, na play. In case lang nag-buy. Or parang, let's say, ako may dala army even though I'm TO or si... Actually, me and Lee, in last that was the last tournament, right, Liam? Parang tayo ata dalawa. The Munchkins.
Yeah, the Munchkins.
Tayo dalawa. We have both armies. Tayo yung TO. Mabuti. Sir Jess was there. And also Sir John Michael, Susan, nandun. So they handled some bit of the stuff. Si Rap, nandun din si Rap. So, yun, nag-handle din sila yun about for the TO recordings while
kami talo ni Liam. Ako pati si Carlo yung naging guinea pig sa situation because yeah. There were
players. Even though kami that, dapat mag-TTO.
Even though kami yung mag-TTO, we were like, you know what? Yeah, well, nandun naman kasi si Rap pati si Jazz. So they were the ones who essentially did the handling. Tapos kami naman, we were like, well, both of us have
and
army.
And some others
so,
na nandun din.
Because we didn't want to parang alienate and make a situation na parang nanalo itong player na ito because naka-buy siya. Like he didn't win because his opponent
pero,
went midway through the battle.
To be honest, if it's a tournament, it comes to the territory talaga.
It comes to the territory. We'd like to
it
think
will,
kasi
yeah.
Na
yeah, if we can avoid it, awesome.
Yeah.
But in guy yeah. that's just how it is.
That's
ang mas mahirap actually is ano eh. For me, if like I already started the event and then some guy comes in and I have to say no because he's late. Oh shit. Sorry dude,
actually,
you're late.
Oh shit.
Actually, really started.
It kind of happened one time if I remember correctly in my Munchkin event, the first event for the new players. There was one player who wasn't able to play at the start of the game because the other player kasi couldn't make it, and I could tell just by looking at him he was really disappointed because it was his first tournament, so he wanted his first experience and first turn to be like memorable and eventful. And at that time yung supposed to be supporter ko or guinea pig ko si Patrick na late din medyo. Pero he was able to play naman at the beginning of the game. Yun nga lang, late lang. But sabi ko, at the very least, you know, get to play pa rin. So,
I think the fair way to resolve that would be to ask like the latecomer, hey, you're late. I can let you participate, but your first game has to be a loss. If you're still cool with that, tuloy.
We haven't thought about that. Ang iniisip na lang namin kasi at that time was since he is late, technically, ang punishment na niya kasi nun is the time constrained and the opponent already had like one victory point for basically being in there na. And the latecomer didn't have any. So, it kind of balances out naman din in a way.
And it's also part of the categories for the points. Strength of schedule. So, part na rin yun sa consideration namin. So, when we're tallying the scores. So, it's one of those tiebreakers. Believe me, some tiebreakers talaga nangyayari. Like,
late.
From...
Sorry.
Yeah, from my last event, yun sa war room nga, nakita ko doon mga... Grabe, tatlo ata yung nagta-tiebreaker. Eh, buti lang, pagdating sa kill points, the last tiebreaker category, oy, lamang sa isa sa point. Oh, panalo siya.
May na.
Yeah.
Because that time, hindi ko alam ano gagawin ko. In truth, I mean, kinescore ko yun, di ba? Matagal ako rin sa score kasi, shit, anong basehan ko dito para...
Basis.
Ma-basis for the tiebreaker ba? Para sino manalo for the third place? Nalawin for the third place.
Actually, interestingly enough, yung first time kong mag-TO sa Munchkin, I had the biggest mistake of doing, which is inad ko yung score ng painting. Kasi I remember I announced it to all the Munchkins na if their army is fully painted, they get 1 point to the total tally of the score. Which at that time I didn't really thought about kasi unang-una, I wasn't so strict with the painting requirements. I only wanted them to paint their models in 3 colors and that's it. You don't even have to base the model itself. You just have to be painted. So, pag painted lahat ng army mo, 1 point. But, you know, to my surprise, the new players that joined the tournament, all of them fully painted. Some of them, I was even amazed that they were able to do it because they just started the hobby within like a month before the tournament started. And then when they came in, it's like, oh, damn. Everything is fully painted.
Grumbarition, bro.
Yeah. It was like, but I should give you more points for this. But you
best catalyst for to have a fully painted. Oops. Tournament. To 5 days. See ya.
No, I was actually quite proud of what happened because most of these newcomers were talagang super dedicated. There was even a time where, before the tournament, I think it was 2 weeks before the tournament started, nag-held up kami ng parang small event lang na kung saan yung mga marunong na sa Age of Sigmar, yeah, pati yung mga bago mag-join together para lang may matuto silang mga gimmicks or techniques na hindi nila alam sa table, mga ganon. And I'm surprised, like, most of them attended in the event and were like, talagang gusto nilang matuto lahat ng matututunan nila para for the event itself.
That's good.
It was, well, yeah.
I gotta give you guys credit for that because you were the ones spearheading them in that direction, man.
Well, that's true. Pero in my case, kasi personally, I find it na parang we were spearheading it. But at the end of the day, kasi it's the amount or the participation of everybody in the event. Yeah. So it was, and it parang
everything is for the community na rin. It's everything for is for the community. It's for them naman eh. So a bit of cooperation naman. So something sabi na fully painted armies. Actually nagulat nga ako sa yun. So for the GT, for our GT, there's a lot of new players. I mean, who didn't go through Munchkins, but they went straight to the 2,000 points, and I'm surprised. 2,000.
Yeah, I know some
of them.
Yeah. See, Zach, like, I was so surprised because naalala ko nun, Zach was like, I want to join the tournament scene. And I'm like, oh, man. I think it was like, what?
Zero
experience. Pero he was able to complete 2,000 points worth of fun. Yeah. So,
that's dedication. Kind of that's
yeah.
Oh, wait. But, so, like, here's an important point to discuss. So, have you guys, alam naman natin nag-GCQ na, have you guys been out? You guys been outside? To NG or Fortress or War Room? Or
no, I haven't stepped out. Actually, I haven't stepped out of our condo area.
I'm too scared.
I'm also scared. Very much scared.
It's kind of funny because I'm the guy who has asthma and really
a car.
Bad. Yeah.
And you also have a car.
No, but I've been ever since even the enhanced community quarantine that we've been experiencing, I've been going out with my mom because she would be like, Kuya, we have to buy groceries. And I'm the only one who is like capable to drive. So I was like, oh man, I have no choice. I have to go.
Well, you're still here. It means you're doing the proper precautions then.
Or it means you're already immune. Or maybe you're a carrier.
Praise Nergo.
Oh no, don't call him.
I don't know.
So like with all of this, sorry. So like with all of this, you know, do you think wala pang vaccine and all. Do you think we should get the chance to play soon? Like even if it's like it's not like the whole yung games the experience, like punta tayong war room, tas nandun tayong lahat and it's fun and all. Probably it'll be just like 4 people in like the entire war room.
Or 3 to 4 people or maybe just 2 people.
Personally, I think it depends on the store itself. Because for example, if Neutral Grounds at the moment, they don't accept any customers to play in their store. Because the government hasn't issued any approval of, you know, hey, you can do some sort of gaming in this area.
Still not part of essential.
Like, prolonged.
So in the foreseeable future, if ever, like, say for example the vaccine's not out yet and stuff, I guess I could see that, because there are a couple of people who've been discussing about potential alternatives to tournament, one being the one that you suggested, which is an elimination match wherein, you know, just Ladder. Two people in, I don't know, in Neutral Grounds Mega Bowl or in a specific day, and then whatever the result is, it will carry over for the next round and stuff like that. So,
like, but the tournament is going to last in a span of like 2-3 months.
It's definitely gonna take longer compared to
longer. Like,
yeah. Oh yeah, with you guys, it's like 22 people, at least.
Well, damn. No, see, that's the other concern that
that's
I have.
That's a good problem to have. 22 like, players.
It's the problem there is like still the consensus of the community. So even if we say, hey, we're gonna be doing an elimination match instead of like the grand tournament that we were hoping to achieve, some of them might not even participate at all due to the fact that it's still dangerous to go out. It's going to be one of those situations where this is definitely not going to be a grand tournament the way we wanted it to be. But if there are still people out there willing to play and willing to do this sort of elimination style, then yeah, we could do something else other than the grand tournament for now.
If there's no any other way, basically, it's a ladder match. It's gonna span for, yes, maybe months, or maybe just maybe a few months long, because of course not everyone's going to participate. Definitely, I can't participate because you know, kasama ko dito is immunocompromised, which is my mom. So even though I might, I can go out, but I don't want to risk infecting her.
Of course,
even some others will also be like that as well.
That's the other funny part too, because it's like I don't think that I will be able to TO this year or until the vaccine comes out. Not because I don't want to; it's mostly because my parents'
health concerns. That's true.
It's better to err.
It's very much, very much.
Of course,
yeah.
It's very much.
Personally, yun din yung ano ko eh. As much as I want to, you know, get the gears back with even just casual play, I feel it's just irresponsible.
I'm just rolling dice.
Kasi parang hindi yata kaya ng konsensya ko if like any one of my friends becomes a casual kid, I'll pinilit ko maglaro. Man.
Yeah.
You're gonna friggin' haunt me forever. No.
It's not just that. It's also like yung integrity ng store. Kasi parang in a way, kahit nasabihin na natin, it's not sponsored by Neutral Grounds or War Room and stuff.
It happened in Neutral Grounds.
It happened there.
Parang madadamay lang din sila.
Madadamay, yeah.
Lalo walang pupunta dun sa venue.
That too, yun pa. Yun pa yung isa dun eh.
Yeah, that's a thing.
So for one thing though,
what you were saying?
I've watched some videos from other hobby groups from other countries. Like the Honest War Gamer. Honest War Gamer is one of those Australian hobby groups for AOS and also 40K. So actually mostly Warhammer. What they've been doing tournaments in Tabletop Simulator. So yun. I don't know if we're going to be considering that in case this whole COVID situation is not going to blow over. And I'm foreseeing it's not really going to blow over soon. So, I don't know. So, yun lang, if people are really want to have tournaments or you really want to play, at least have that feel of rolling the dice, you might be considering yun na lang na ATS would be the norm. Personally, I think TTS is good or any other simulator game, but I kind of slightly feel like you're. Anong motto ko diyan? Try before I buy.
Yeah, try before you buy. Actually, that's one of the reasons why we play the tabletop version. Cause like, I want to try this build or list. Tara, Carlo, try muna natin bago ko bilhin ito.
I'm going to be like the devil's advocate on that one. Because the problem with that, for example, I'm gonna demo, let's say, Guild Ball to some new guy using that. And then he's just gonna say, I'm enjoying this. Why would I need to buy the models pa?
That's one of my gripes going into the actual miniatures.
Personally, for me, I find that it just really depends on the person. Yeah, because the feeling of being able to roll the dice and the model, ikaw mismo yung nagpaint nun, it's completely different from.
It's completely different. That's true. That's really
one thing I'm trying to avoid. Social interaction.
It's a game. It's geeky, but it's like social.
Yes, very much.
You get to talk to your opponent. Oy, dude, musta? Tara tayo.
And for one thing though, you're not a stranger to them because they know your face. So if you're gonna do something stupid, like cheating or someone sitting behind the screen, I really don't trust much. That's why I quitted playing online games like Dota because, you know, it's very much toxic because you can hide your identity. Playing tabletop, it's very much, parang umayos ka. You're going to be a better person.
I can attest to that.
You don't want... I'm sorry if anyone's offended or anything.
I'm pretty sure we've gone through at some point in our life in the hobby wherein we've become a changed person in some way or another.
For me, that's more positive than negatives, I gotta admit.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's why I'm not stopping.
That's why. Why the hell are you doing this? That's why I'm really not considering ETS as a very good alternative. Hopefully, everything goes over.
Yeah, for the time being.
Yun na lang if anyone wants to scratch an itch. Or if you're very rich or you have the budget, you can buy a car and drive to someone else.
Hey, Carlo, you have like you guys started that TTS Facebook group, right? Kasama ka na ba nun, Leo?
Wala doon si Leo. I didn't start it. It was Si Neil.
Okay.
I think you know him, sir.
Not as much as I know you guys, but there's this new group they call it TTS Philippines.
Tabletop Simulator Philippines.
Okay.
Alternative right now.
Okay.
For me,
so for anyone with
TTS is okay. Problem lang sa kanya. You have to buy Tabletop Simulator first. Yes, Vassal is all free.
Wait.
I think that's it.
Yeah.
Hindi 3D si Vassal. It's flat. It's like top view flat. Fighting. But it's free.
It really depends naman, sir. If anyone just wants to have that feel of playing and rolling dice on the game, Vassal is good.
Pero
if someone who wants to see models in Tabletop Simulator. It's also good, even though it looks like Paper Hammer.
Although I got to join, sino ba to? Sila Jack Juan, they're 40k players from Cebu.
Mm-hmm.
Then they were trying TTS long before the group started pa. They were really like looking forward to pushing more into that because now of COVID. But ang naging problem, they were trying to stream it. I couldn't even see the stream.
Internet connection.
That's the problem kasi. Like we said, problem ng TTS is who's the server? I mean, when me and Liam played, I was the server. Si Liam umabot ng 999.
It was a terrible story.
Wait, Liam. Amazing. I transfer ko nga. You'll be the host. I transferred the host to him. Pag ako yung pumasok na, oh shit. I only have 75 ping. But shit, mas okay pa bang ganyan because Liam has a better internet connection than mine. Yun din, I also played TTS with Sir Chip Anisco and Nathaniel. They're the people. They're the Alimol group. They're the ones who actually told me about TTS. Try daw namin ganun. The first game I played was Mark right there. It's good. For skirmish games, skirmish level games, TTS is also good. It's very much quick. Quick in terms of TTS time. But it still takes you an hour to finish.
I mean, if you're going to if you're gonna ask me to play, I prefer Vassal AOS or 40k rather than TTS because pointless para sa akin. Ano ako eh, I'm more of a performance over forma guy. I mean, yeah, you have like pretty 3D models, but if the whole experience is
draining, time
slow and sluggish, parang no. Maasar lang yung kalaro ako.
Because I timed it ngayon games namin ni Liam sa TTS, 1,000 points umabot kami 2 hours parang isip ko shit. So if it's gonna be a 2K points 2 hours. 2 hours plus 2 so mga 4 hours,
4 hours. Back in a day.
Oh my god.
Kalaro ko si Tiny ng War Machine Vassal, 25 points umabot kami 3 hours. Because there was no mic. There was no webcam. Trying to explain to him via chat.
Just type in.
This is how you move your models. 3 hours, 25 point game, man. Jesus Christ.
That's one thing that's very hard to consider because not everyone has the equipment. I mean, si Joshua nga, di ba, parang napilit natin mag-order siya ng headphones.
Yeah, he didn't have Joshua a mic. Lapid,
yeah.
So he was like, I'm gonna order a mic and Shopee.
So I can join and play TTS with you guys. Pero yeah, if things go so long itong ECQ, GCQ, or just this lockdown, we might be considering it as options. Those Vassal. So it really depends on the person who wants to play with it. Vassal for performance, or wants to be pa-forma, or you just want to look at pretty figures. Or pretty paper figures because yun nga, not all models are 3D in TTS.
That's true.
So, yun,
if you guys are like going to play or after you played, just like post on everywhere, get people to like try TTS, Vassal, whatever, War Table, try.
Actually, more safer. Recruiting new players, even though they can't play in this situation. I mean, for those new players, if they have TTS, little budget, we can always show it to them over there. Which is kind of hard din. Magagawa ng online live streaming.
Interesting.
For me, it's primarily since we're the ones hosting the events and stuff. It's like personal responsibility natin on how to like, okay guys, we're not having tournaments anytime soon. So, eto muna until it's safe. Like go back out into the streets.
Actually, interestingly enough, it might sound hypocritical coming from me because I'm a couple of people know me as one of those players who are sometimes lazy in terms of the hobby, specifically when it comes to painting. Pero those 2 months na kung saan we didn't do anything but just stay at home, and I was like, honestly, this is like the perfect moment wherein we get to go to the side of the hobby wherein we normally not really ignore, but more like we tend to skip sometimes, which is essentially painting.
That's a whole different episode for us.
Yeah. That's a whole different episode.
For sure.
A whole different episode.
For sure. Yeah. Pero it was one of those things that I find it really funny though, because it's like the moment they announced the COVID-19 situation in the Enhanced Community Karting, majority of the players that were supposed to join in the Grand Tournament were like, oh, finally, I can take a break from painting my models and not rush for the tournament.
Hey man, that's true. My table. Look, I have Marvel, War Machine.
I have Demon. I have a lot of stuff too.
Like, all year.
Also, my stuff in Adin. This is what I'm currently working on, but of course.
Wow,
Black Dragon.
Yeah, for a big
Black choice. Dragon. Yeah.
But yeah.
The whole lover episode about that. What's ironic is I reconnected to my past hobby, which is digital painting.
Oh my man, you're.
That's what...
Yeah, he's been doing.
I never Ano yung chapter na ginawa mo?
Iron Snakes and Karkaradons.
Karkaradons.
Dang.
I reconnected to that hobby because, well, for one reason is I had no more Naln Oil, I had no more Rickland Flesh Shade. At that time, hindi pa nagde-deliver NG, parang, shit, I want to scratch that itch. Because I don't want to continue my painting, parang, yes, nalagay ko na lahat ng base paints. Shit, I don't have black shade. How can I continue this? I'm the type of person.
Discovered ko naman with this whole, I do get to paint more. Pero the problem by having more time to paint more, tinitignan ko na ngayon yung the paint stock that I have. Ang dami sa kanilang, they're like dead already. So, especially in the Philippines, unless you find out a way to keep them liquid.
The biggest tip that I would probably go with in terms of the paint is just do not stop them in a place wherein it's humid or really, really hot. Dun, mabilis natutuyo yung paint. Keep them in a very cool place and they would last a long, long time. I still have the old GW paint na yung color black pa yung takip niya sa taas. I still have it and it's still in good consistency.
Hey, like, man.
Hindi siya natuyo.
Did you guys believe I still have that old flesh wash? Pag silip ko sa kanya, natuyo dahil hindi ko ginamit.
You live that long. Not long. One thing din, if you keep on painting stuff, though, it's gonna increase on your cost because, shit, wala na akong backlog. Time to buy more stuff.
Wow! No, I don't think that there's gonna be a situation.
No backlog? Damn, son. Really?
You might never know. I mean, siyempre, with all that things, parang, I think that's the only thing that's in the back of our mind psychologically telling us.
No,
like
some of us here have been in the hobby for like how many years? In my case personally, it's been like 10 years, and backlog has always been like a part of the hobby.
Hey man, I'm not rich.
You're not.
Yun yung thing, nung nakikita, narinig ko yung mga usapan pagkano, dami kong backlog. What's backlog? Ngayon, holy crap! I have unopened boxes. Why? Stupid. Pero like right now, they're coming out with new stuff for Demons in 40K. I'm sure they're gonna be coming out with new stuff for
Sigmar.
Okay. May pag-asa pa, Plague Bearers.
The new things that the demons are coming out are just additional rules and.
Yep.
Reading from the spoilers, I was like, oh man, this is kind of underwhelming and somewhat disappointing for...
In 40K.
Well, specifically 40K. For... Yeah, in 40K. Specifically for Nurgle. I was like...
They wanted to...
They did say, though.
They put in the rules so you get to play with the big models.
They did, pero...
Rotten Flesh.
Pero... I was just disappointed because it was like... Compared to the other releases that they have done in the past for the other factions, the demons kind of gotten the short end of the stick in terms of like additional rules and cool things. Like reading about it, it was like, really? That's it? Plus one wound? Like,
and then on the opposite side of the fence, Grey Knights got what?
that's the thing that like kind of tickled me. It's like, Grey Knights got a lot of these cool new rules and like really ridiculous capabilities, and then I look at Demons and Chaos, and it's like, what happened? It's like, it's like the same. You didn't add anything to
sell,
it,
bro.
Hey man, they sell.
Sell, not demons. The enemies of mankind. do not provide hopefully a good revenue Ed. For GW.
That's true. But
hopefully Night Ed is gonna change it for them. Yeah.
Yeah. Hopefully Night Ed is gonna change.
Hey man.
No, actually it's probably gonna make it worse because tanks can shoot in close combat. Like
it might never
That's the only thing that demons have in terms of like being able to stop tanks from firing their guns. And now Night Edition is like, we're allowing all tanks to fire even if they're in close combat. And I'm like, well, what's the point of me teleporting my demons in front of your vehicles to stop them from shooting at us?
No, you put the Bloodthirster to engage the tank. So the tank can shoot at something else except the Bloodthirster engaging.
We're actually hoping that that's how the shooting works in 440K, kind of like
Sigmar. Ganun nga. The tank can shoot, but not at the model engaging it.
Well, I can't say because I haven't read any of the latest so far in the 9th edition.
But in Age of Sigmar, you can only shoot the one who's engaging you. Not exactly engaging you. Within 3 inches. So anyone within 3 inches, that's your only target. Which is
we're hoping for it to be like that, but from the sound of it, it's like no, you can still shoot anybody even if you're in close combat.
Why?
No, it was part of the plan. We need to sell tanks this year. Here's the sentence to change it all.
Oh man!
Bring back armored company. Yahoo!
Connecting back to AOS, I think they're going to do that too for monsters. I'm hoping because I have a lot of monster figures here from the Gorgons. You know, the Beastmen. The Beastmen are known for all of their monster figures. They have a lot of monster options, but all of them suck. All of them suck. You're just gonna bring it, pero wala lang astig lang siya dyan. So hopefully, with the new update for Sons of Behemoth, or kung ano may new edition, or even in just the General's Handbook. For one thing though, General's Handbook, I'm kind of looking forward to it. Anong new changes? Because wala na, no rules changes eh. Just points changes and maybe changes to the missions and battle plans as well. And hopefully for War Scroll changes, so I just want my Beastmen. Okay.
But that's like the smart thing to do. I mean, it's the same thing with Steamroller. You don't mess with the actual rules of what's existing out there. You just give him a new set of tournament rules to play with. So it's still fresh and it's still dynamic.
That's true. In this edition, the General's Handbook 2019, the deployments, lot of new abilities from new factions saying that you need to be within your opponent's territory or within your territory. But it's very weird on GHB 2019 because kakaiba eh, iba yung itsura ng territories niya eh. Some are like triangle formation, some are just one-fourth of the board is your territory, the center is a no-man's land. So how can you use your abilities?
Also, the biggest problem that GHB 2019 that they didn't really address because at that time, I don't think they were like still encouraging it, is the fact that all of those objective-based games that they laid out are for a 6x4 table. And we were like, our tournaments are mostly 4x4. And we're like, how do we do this sort of weird angle for a 4x4 instead of a 6x4? So we're hoping for this 2020 General's Handbook, they would have at the very least, for a 4x4 type of setup. 4x4. Yeah.
Actually, they already have. It's called Meeting Engagements. It's for one-day tournaments.
I think GW is looking into the different
lower point
table, the smaller table sizes.
Look at
Kill Team, look at Warcry. It's like a 2x3 or some weird small
quadrilateral.
If you don't require your players to have a big table space, you get more players interested in your game. Because it allows you to play on like a Starbucks or like a Jollibee.
You get
your games in.
I think it was mostly thanks to the fact that they've made games like Warhammer Underworlds, because there were moments where I've seen a lot of people like in the community who's like posting pictures of like them playing Warhammer and Underworlds in like the weirdest of places that you can't even think of, like one of them being like they're playing in the airplane of all places. So I'm just like, damn,
it's just a board.
Yeah.
And the smart thing is GW provides that stiff board to be able to play. You not long, that's your one side, and then your opponent has to bring his board.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. Tapos yung gagawin niyo yung nakaganito.
It kind of gives GW like a sense of like, you know, wow, like there's so many people playing our games that are like, you know, small in terms of the table size. So maybe we should like, you know, for people to get into Age of Sigmar or Warhammer 40K more, maybe we could put more into a 4x4 setting instead of always focusing on the 6x4.
Yeah, that's what they're doing. So
that's the smart direction for GW to take.
That's what they said about our 9th edition, that the game size also depended on the table size. It's really good, because I don't think it was a consistent kind game or 40k.
Carlo. Sorry to cut you off, but you're cutting actually.
I'm cutting? Okay. I'm
sorry. Yeah, your voice is cutting, like it's splitting like from time to time. Yeah.
sorry. I think it's because you're streaming now. Because, you know, work's over.
Okay.
No stream. But it's okay. Can you hear me now, really?
We can kind of hear you, but it's like still cutting-ish.
I guess it's like a, yeah, we can call this like an episode for today. a good time. Like it'll be a good space to like sign off. It was nice talking to you guys. Get to dissect your thoughts on in the situation natin sa Pilipinas on how to move forward with our tournaments, AOS, War Machine. I was hoping to get like some 40k guys or whatever other game system guys, maybe for a different date. Maybe I can invite the Gundam players also. So for me, I was just like, one day I want to make content. I'll post something on Pinoy War Gamer. Oh, I want to talk to the Age of Sigmar guys that I chatted
with. Actually, that's one of the things that I've been like thinking from time to time, where it's like, oh, maybe I could like post a couple of like pictures and then some words of like maybe tips or something. But then I realized that there's a lot of that right now on the internet that you can just simply share to people in the groups. So this kind of like talking situation we're in, it's related to just us here in the Philippines. You know, it's definitely something that's you won't be able to find anywhere else. So
yeah, that's my focus, because you're correct. Battle reports, how to paint, unboxing, go everywhere else for that. But like for me, since like we are heavily invested with our community, I guess they probably want to hear from us our plans on moving forward, our tournaments, our casual games. So sorry guys, wag muna, ayaw namin kayong mamatay. Sorry.
Yeah.
Hindi kayo na kontensya namin.
Nothing.
So, ano muna, GTS, Basel, Martable, whatever. Hey, I saw like, sino ba yun? Mini War Gaming, naglaro sila via Zoom. I don't know how they pulled that off. They played Warhammer 40K via Zoom.
It requires a lot of setup for sure.
This is the world we're like living in now, and we don't want to lose touch with our brothers in the game. At least we have like social media and all that. But still, thank you guys for wasting the afternoon
No, talking. It's honestly. Well, no, because this is actually a good opportunity to. This is actually a good opportunity to speak out to majority of the community, because it's like some of the members of the community have been like asking me personally, oh, what's gonna happen now? Like, is there gonna be another tournament in the foreseeable future? And I'm just like, I mean, until the vaccine's out, not gonna happen.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. Be responsible. Okie dokie. Thank you again, guys. Stay
safe.
Thanks for the call.
Let's
do this again soon.
Yep, we'll do.
Alrighty.
Keep on hugging people.
Yeah, keep on hugging. Bye.
Take care. Bye.